it on a string, Tracy Island, time traveling.
Hi, I'm Richard Antonucci, and this is your Friday News Show. First, let's take a look at our reporter, Aaron Fry, speaking with Simon Cox about the NU Choir Program.
Hey everybody, so we're right outside the choir room with Simon Cox, a member of the Chamber Choir. I'm going to ask him a few questions about choir. So, Simon, when's the next event?
We're going to be doing a spring concert on the Equinox in February. And that's pretty much the only concert we have coming up. And we're going to Europe on March 23rd.
Wow. How much time would you say you put into choir a week, maybe?
Well, every day I'm here at 6:30 and do choir until first period ends. So it's at least 2 hours a day. It's 5 days a week. It's like 10 hours a week. And if we have after school practices like we did last night, that's another 3 hours. So
lots of time.
Plenty of time.
Would you say that you enjoy choir?
It's my favorite period of the day, honestly. I wouldn't do it 10 hours a week if I didn't enjoy it.
All right, thanks for doing this interview. I'll go in there and do your singing. Go get him, Tiger.
Now let's move on to Troy Woolard with our community report.
Hey, this is Troy Woolard here, telling you guys about the 13th annual Wild and Scenic Film Festival coming this January 15th. It's brought on by Circle, or South Yuba River Citizen League. This film festival returns with another incredible selection of films to change your world. Each year, the Wild and Scenic Film Festival draws top filmmakers, celebrities, leading activists, social innovators, and well-known world adventurers to the historic downtowns of Nevada City and Grass Valley, California. Considered one of the nation's premier environmental and adventure film festivals, this year's films combine stellar filmmaking, beautiful cinematography, and first-rate storytelling to inform, inspire, and ignite solutions and possibilities to restore the Earth and human communities while creating a positive future for the next generation. Festival goers can expect to see award-winning films about nature, community activism, adventure, conservation, water, energy, and climate change, wildlife, and environmental studies. Tickets range from $15 to $350 depending on where you're going, and it should be a fun one. Good to see you out there.
Moving on to sports, here are the top five plays of your NU boys varsity basketball team. Now we're going to cover the pros and cons of the addition of the Chromebooks here at Nevada Union.
What do you think about partnership having Chromebooks, and would you like to have one too?
Yes, I would like to have one. I've heard good and bad, but I think it'd be kind of cool to have one.
It'd be great, you know, moving forward. Because the school is so old and the computers are so awful. So Chromebooks, yes, let's do it.
Less paper.
Save the trees.
Okay, I think that the rest of the students in the school should have a Chromebook because I'm super jealous of partnership gets them.
Standing and
I really don't care.
What are the pros and cons of partnership having Chromebooks?
I think that it's good to always be able to access the internet when you need it and to have your own personal school computer. I think that's really great. But I think a big con, would be carrying around the laptop bag everywhere we go.
For pros, for instance, we can take our Chromebook anywhere we go. It's our personal computer until the end of the year. We have to give it back. We can take our notes, we can study anywhere, we can look, like if we're confused on something, we can just look it up, we can, like if we need to study for a test, we can just do like a cram jam real quick on the Chromebook. For a con, I would say that when we received the Chromebooks, we were told that we would have access to almost every site, such as like YouTube or like just other websites that we can use for information, but those are still blocked. And if those are blocked, then studying will be a lot harder.
A definite pro is that it's paperless and we don't have to carry around our big textbooks. A bad thing about it is when we have our assignment, our classroom discussions based around the internet and the internet is down, the lesson plan for the day goes out the window and we have to improvise.
That's it for your Friday News Show. Have a great weekend, miners.
Come to find you for in some velvet morning. Years too late, she's a silver lining, Lone Ranger riding through an open space.